Are you going to help me loom? Oh, what? Pretty bird. Pretty bird. You going to sing? You going to whistle? No, you're going to mess with my loom. Hey, don't be knocking that off of there. Don't be chewing those pieces off. What? What? Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? Hey. You're such a goofy bird. Such a goofy bird. Hello, and welcome to a new tutorial. I'm sorry, I apologize. I could not help but put Sebastian as the lead-in to this bracelet. I just wanted him to make his debut. You may have seen it on IG, but I just wanted to add him to this video. So, we are going to do Out of the Shadows. Oh, now he's talking. Out of the Shadows by The Looming Artist. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous bracelet, 7 pin bars wide. If you're not following The Looming Artist, please, please give her a follow. She has some amazing, amazing designs on her account. I just love them. Love looking at all of them. So give her a follow. Okay, so I'm going to put that aside. The first thing we're going to do is drop a band. That's my closing band. I'm going to bring a band to the left, another one. We'll bring them also out to the right, just like so. And then we are going to bring them up. Now, for this, I have just, make sure you push your bands down. I have decided to use these. Very pretty. Only problem is that I only had enough for one side, so I'm also using these. So I can't get a better shot of both of them. So I will be alternating between the two of these for this design. So I will add my beaded band. Goodness, I didn't want those sleeves showing now, did I? A little chilly here today, so I wanted to wear a jacket. Okay, plain band, beaded band. You get the idea. I'll do that all the way up to the top, and I think I still need to look and see how far down she stopped with this, but we'll go over to the other side. Plain band. Make sure I'm picking the right ones because I want them the same on both sides. Beaded band. I sometimes have a problem getting those beaded bands on there. Plain band and beaded band. Okay, when I come back, I will let you know how far to stop from the top. I will have done it and I'll give you a look-see. See you soon. I have finished with my top layer. Now, I like my bracelets a little shorter because I like to use the magnetic clasps on them, but you will take it 1, 2, 3 from the top if you're going by the flipogram, but I'm dropping it down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? So what you'll do at the top is you'll go diagonal in towards the top, straight across, and then diagonal towards the top again and meet right here. So that's 1, 2, 3 pins from the top, where normally on the bracelet you might stop right here. Okay? So we are going to lay our next layer. And for that next layer, I choose to use Egyptian brown. Very pretty. Okay, so 2 pin bars in, first pin, straight up. It's your first one. Oh, and these get sticky. Your next pin will go from, your next band will go from here to here. Okay, so diagonally down, and from that center pin, diagonally up do that one more time, and then we'll go to the other side. Make sure that you push your bands down. So, straight up, diagonally to the left, down, and diagonally up, and to the right. Okay, let's do this on the other side. Second pin bar in from the right, first pin. You will go straight up. From that second pin, you will go diagonally down to the right and diagonally up to the right. I'll do that one more time. From the second pin up now, you'll go straight up, diagonally, diagonally down to the right and diagonally up to the right. So follow this pattern all the way up, and I'll come back and show you how it ends. Okay, I am at the top of my loom. I laid this band out here, and the last band I laid was right here. So we're going to go ahead and do the next level. Hold on just a second. I am back, and this next part is very, very simple. We're going to go from one second pin bar in, first pin, diagonal to the right, straight across to the right, diagonal to the right, and straight across to the right. And you will do that pattern all the way up. I'll go to the other side with you. Second pin bar from the right, one, two, starting here. There will be a diagonal. I know it looks like I'm going to the right, but to the left. We will take the next pin across. And next, diagonal up and towards the center, and then one straight across. Okay, don't forget to push your pins down. So this is an exact mirror image. It's diagonal to the center, out to the right and left, diagonal to the center, and out to the right. So finish that pattern, and then I will be back with you at the top. Okay, so I finished that pattern, which was the down diagonal and then across. You will stop right here, third pin bar in at the top. Same thing here, third pin bar in at the top. That is your last band. Okay. Now we're just going to lay single chains. We're going to lay single chains on the third and the fifth pin bar all the way up to the top. I will start you with it and then come back. So one, straight up, straight up, straight up. And the same thing on the other side. Just straight up the loom. Okay? And finish that up. The single chains on one, two, three, and five, all the way up. And I'll meet you back here when you're done. I have finished to the top, stopped on the third pin bar and the fifth pin bar, where the cross bands are, our border bands are. Okay. This is what it should look like. Fingers crossed. Okay. So, I believe we have two more layers of bands to lay. I am using my Persian black, so pretty. Middle pin bar, straight up. Diagonally down, oops, sticky bands, down to the left, diagonally down to the right, okay, middle pin, straight up, diagonally down to the left, and diagonally down to the right, very simple pattern, okay, straight up, left, right, all the way up, and I'll meet you back here when I'm finished. I am at the top, and my last three bands were a diagonal here, and then one connecting right here between the very top, straight up. Okay, next thing we're going to do is lay the center band, and I apologize for the crinkling because I forgot to pull my bands. Oh, I said center band. Oh, my apologies. I meant the border band. So remember I said we were going to put a double border on here. So we'll start from that center to the left, to the right. I'm sorry, and to the left again. To the left diagonal, straight up. We'll take that all the way up and follow the border the same as you did for the first one that we laid. And in my case, it was a Simplicity Black. Back to that center band, to the right, and then straight up. Okay, so finish that, and then I will meet you back here. I will continue to lay my bands and see you in just a moment. I am back, and when I got to the top, I brought everything in on a diagonal, straight across, and another diagonal, and met right here in the center. Okay, I'll flip that around. I have already put my cap band on. We're going to loom up the top border bands that we just laid. Okay, and I believe we're going to the right first, yes. So go into the center band, the center cap band, grab your top band, which is the one going to the right for me, depends on how you laid it. Okay, loop it to the right, grab that one, loop it to the right, go in, grab the next top band, which is that border band, loop it to the right, and whoop, not both of those, and then straight up, do that all the way up this side, and we'll do the other side here. I'm going to go in to that cap band in the center, grab the top band, loop it back to itself, the next top band, loop it back to itself, and all the way around the outside of the border. Okay, finish that up, and I will meet you back here once you get everything looped up. And then we will go on to the next process. Okay, so loop all of these outer border bands, just the top ones, all the way to the top, and bring it into the center. I have finished all the way up to the top. This is my top layer of border bands. They go diagonally up towards the center, in towards the center, and up towards that last pin. That's where they'll meet. Okay, let's get down to the bottom here. I need you to pay attention because we are looping the center here, and we're also looping these single chains right here and here. And we don't want to miss them. So we're going to go into the cap band. We're going to grab that first band and put it back to itself. We're going to go to the left, grab that top band. Oops, I have two. Just the top band. Bring it up and back to itself. Go over to the right, which is one, two, third pin bar to the from the right, first pin, grab that and bring it up. Okay, and then we are going to go one second pin up in the center, grab the first band, which should be to the left, bring it back to itself, grab the band on the right hand side, bring it back to itself. So sorry. Grab the center band and bring it up. Drop down to the left. Grab that top band. Gotta get that top band. I'll go over to the side here and get it. Grab that top band and bring it straight up. Go over to the right. One, two, third pin bar. And grab that top band and bring it straight up. Ooh, give me a little bit of trouble. Straight up. And we'll go into the center, grab the diagonal that's going to the left, bring it back to itself, grab the diagonal that is going to the right, bring it back to itself, and bring the center band straight up. I'll do that one more time for you. Before we do these, we want to remember to drop down and grab these center pins. If you don't, it will fall apart. And yeah, we don't want that happening. So go in, grab that single chain that's going straight up, close it up, and now you can do your center bands. Go back to the middle, diagonal out to the left, diagonal out to the right, and the single chain straight up. Drop down to the left, grab that single chain, pull it straight up, go over here, 1, 2, 3, 4 pin bar, 4 pins up, third pin bar from the right, grab that single chain and bring it straight up. So before you do these diagonals here, you want to make sure that the center from the previous pin is up and that these two bands right here are straight up. Okay, so finish that pattern all the way up and I will come back and show you what it's supposed to look like. Okay, I am back and I ended up with this straight up to the right and to the left, and this is what your loom should look like. Let's go down, give you another little quick peek in the middle here, and make sure you push all of your bands down. Okay. Now, pay close attention because we're going to actually work all of these bands right here. Okay, start on the left-hand side, second pin bar, first pin. We're going to go in and grab that top band and bring it straight up. Okay, we're going to drop down on this diagonal here, third pin bar, grab that top band, and bring it back to itself. And we're going to go in, and there's a cross band in here. So 1, 2 up, second pin bar, second pin. We're going to go in and grab that cross band and bring it back to itself to the right. Oh, I don't want to break that. So let's give it a little tug on the side here. Okay. Come on, loosen up. There we go. Okay. So now what we're going to do is go into that same pin, second pin bar, second pin, reach in, grab the top band, which is the diagonal down. I have just one. Oh, it's a little tight in there. Okay, just be careful and bring it back to itself. Okay, reach into that same pin. Grab the next one, which is this diagonal right here, and we are going to bring it back to itself. Didn't realize that was so tight. Come on, please do not snap. Be very careful when doing this. Okay, there we go. All right, so I'll do this with you one more time. You can always rewind. Reach into that same pin, grab that top band, bring it straight up, drop down and over to the right. You want to reach in there and grab that diagonal band. Oops, looks like I have two. And I do. Reach in, grab that diagonal band. Very carefully bring it back to itself. Go into the same pin that you just put a band on. Reach in, grab that cross band. Bring it to the right. Oh goodness. I'm just a little tight. It might be the bands that I'm using. Okay, there we go. Excuse me. Go into, okay, so this way, that way. Go into that same pin, grab the top band, and bring it back to itself. Oh, I know this is pretty scary to me. Look at this. Pretty scary. Okay. Go in, grab the next band that's on top, which is a diagonal to the left, and bring it up. Make sure you use good quality stretchy bands on this, or maybe not stretchy, but good quality bands that are not going to break. Sorry for the hand. Okay, I think I will go ahead and do this side one more time and try to keep my hand out of the way this time. Reach in, one, two, third pin up, second pin bar. Grab that band, bring it straight up. Third pin bar, third pin. Go in and grab this diagonal band here. If I can find it. So one on the bottom, I believe. Yes. I'll give it a stretch out first. And then bring it back to itself. Go into the pin that you just laid that band in. Going to grab this cross band right here. Grab that cross band and bring it back to itself. Okay. Go into the band that hush, Sebastian. Is it the pin 1, 2, 3, 4 up? We're going to bring these two diagonals back to themselves. Maybe if I give it a little tug, a little bit of a stretch, it'll be easier to come off. Okay. Go in and grab the next top band, which is this diagonal here, and bring it back to itself. Okay. You can always straighten these bands by giving a little bit of a tug and making sure they're in the right position. Okay. Oop, came off, didn't it? Oh, goodness, don't lose that. There we go. I just want to make sure these are opposed. Okay, there we go. Got it. Goodness. All right, we're going to go over to the other side. Rewind if you have to. It's just a little tight in there. Not a big deal. Just make sure your bands are good quality bands. So we're going to go into the second pin bar from the right, first pin. Grab that band, bring it straight up. Okay, going to drop down to the third pin bar, grab this diagonal right here, and bring it back to itself, like so. We're going to go into a second pin bar, second pin, grab that top band, which is this cross band right here, and bring it back to itself. Bands don't want to come off. I'm just trying to keep my hands out of the way. Apologize. Then we're going to go into that same pin and bring these diagonals right here back to themselves. Go in, grab that band, give it a little bit of a stretch, and then bring it back to itself. This time I'm going to try to give this a little nudge. There we go. Go in, grab the next band, which is that top diagonal going out to the right, and bring it back to itself. There we go. Okay, I'm going to do this pattern one more time for you. Second pin bar, second pin. Go in, grab the last band on there, which is the one that's going straight up. Bring it back to itself. Drop down to the left, this diagonal here. Grab that band. Well, come on. Doesn't want to cooperate. There it is. And bring it back to itself. Okay. Go into that same pin bar. Grab this cross band right here. Give it a little stretch and bring it back to itself. And we'll take these two out, and that will be the end of that pattern. I didn't pull that very well, did I? Okay. Bring it back to itself. I'm going to give this a little tug to try to get this around where it belongs. Bear with me, please. There we go. And it goes like this. Then you reach in, grab that last diagonal band, and bring it up and diagonally to the right. Okay, hopefully you got that pattern. Sebastian, my goodness. Hopefully you got that pattern. If not, rewind as many times as you need to. And I will be back at the top when I'm finished this. And I believe the last thing we have to do are the border bands, and then we can pull it off the loom. I am back at the top of my loom, and this is the very last band that you laid right here, okay, on both sides. So this is what it should look like. Just like that, okay? The next thing we're going to do is the border, and I believe that this side is my, yes, this is where I'm going to start because it is on the top, and I'm pretty sure you know how to loop out the borders, but I will take it when it's going to be tight. Okay, to the left, go in, grab the bottom band, bring it out to the left, the next bottom band, out to the left, and this might be tight because there are a lot of bands on these outside pins here, so just be careful when you're looping it up. Give it a little pull and bring it up and over. Now, I'm not going to stretch this too much because I don't want to break any bands. So you can leave it where it just looks, you know, kind of straight, or go in and give it a little wiggle to get that teardrop shape. Go back over to the center, grab that band, bring it to the right, and we're taking the bottom bands only because that's all that's left. Okay, bringing them out to the right. That last band, if I can get it, let me go in here. There we go. Bring it out to the right. Bottom band straight up. Again, just if you get this kind of a shape where it's straight and doesn't look like a teardrop, that's fine. You can leave it just like that and continue to loom, or you can go in and pull the bands away and give it that shape. Because when you pull it off, it's not really going to matter. It will fall into place there. So finish looming the border bands all the way up to the top, and I will meet you back there and show you how to close that off. And we will also take it off the loom. I am back, and I have finished my border bands all the way to the very top pin center. I had previously laid a band, a closure band. I'm going to go in through all of those, grab that band, bring it up, attach it to my hook. And since C-clips and I do not get along, I'm going to use my trusty little plastic safety pin. You can use a bobby pin, you can use whatever you want, a regular safety pin, bobby pin, paper clip, just so that you have it to where it's not going to fall apart and it has actually grabbed all of those bands. Okay, this is what my loom looks like, and I will be taking, actually I'll be taking it off shortly. Give me just a moment, please. Okay. I'm back, and we are going to take this off of the loom. Going to start over on the left hand side and carefully lift those pins, releasing the tension on the left hand side from the border. I'm going to go over to the right hand side and do the exact same thing. Okay, now you can take them off like this, or you can start down here and lift them. But I prefer to go from the inside, I'm sorry, from the outside in, and I'm not, don't confuse myself. Okay, so take this off of the loom, and I will be right back. I have taken this off of the loom, and I absolutely love it. I have some beads and bands to fix, and I was going to add a cup chain up the side here, but let's see if you can see it. Sort of has a little valley in the center, So I am going to, let's see, I have this rhinestone cup chain. Sorry for the noise. I have this rhinestone cup chain, and I am going to put that right up the center. Isn't that beautiful? Oh my gosh, I'm in love with this. Okay, well, I have some bands to fix, and if you enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you wish. If you make this design, please hashtag the looming artist, Lila's Gigi, and out of the shadows. Out of the Shadows, I believe, is the name of this bracelet. It is absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to take that chain off there and show you that I dropped it down, if you take a look, because I like to add magnetic clasps here. If you had taken it all the way to the top, it would have fit perfectly to use the C-clip. Oh my gosh, I am just loving this. Okay, until next time, until next tutorial, have a great day. And Sebastian says goodbye. Bye-bye.